Hey everyone, I'm Kara McLean with the Barn Church and Ministries, and just want to thank you for watching this week's episode of Reload. Make sure to comment because we really would love to hear from you and share away this video if it impacts your life, because we just want to encourage the body of Christ and get all of us working together in unity to advance the kingdom of God, because that is important in these days, very important. So today I want to talk about presence, not stage presence, not your presence at a game or gymnastics meet, but the presence of the Lord. There is truly a movement of worshipers happening upon the earth right now who are rising up and focusing solely on his presence. Why? Because a moment in the Lord's presence changes you forever. It marks you. You can never escape that moment. You can't go back and pretend like it didn't happen. It just changes you from the inside out. And his presence, his felt presence, is what will pull us through trials and tribulations that we're certainly going to face. So I am here today. We are here from the barn, just really encouraging you to seek his presence, seek his kingdom, seek his presence above all else. And when you've allowed yourself to let go and just seek his presence without needing to understand how it all works and where are those tingly feelings coming from and all that stuff, he will encounter you. He longs to encounter you. It says that in his word, he longs to encounter you. We can ask for wisdom and we can ask for knowledge, and knowledge can be gained by reading the Bible, and all of those things are really good. But without his presence, it's not whole. They're only half. And I don't know about you, but I don't want half. I want all. I want all God has. I don't want to be half in with God. I don't want to be 99.9% in with God, because if I'm only 99.9% in, I'm still all out, right? And we're never going to have the capability of understanding all of God. God is mysterious. He does things that don't make any sense to us, but he sees the bigger picture way better than we ever could. So everything makes sense to him. He does some things that maybe cause us to scratch our head once in a while and go, huh, but he knows what he's doing. And when you have his presence, when you've experienced him in a real and a tangible way, you don't have to understand. You just trust. Heck, I don't even want to understand all the intricacies of God, and I don't need to, because I know by his presence that he is always good. He is always alive and he's always there for us, because his presence is real and it has marked me and it will mark you. And we have to be okay with mystery. We have to be okay with not knowing everything. We have to be okay with, not understanding every piece of him and not every piece of how God works. And that's where trust and faith comes in. Faith is the evidence of things not seen, right? We have faith in God because we know that he's there. And when you have a moment in his presence, it's more than head knowledge, it becomes heart knowledge. And that is what changes lives. I have seen so many people, they know so much about the word and they know so much about what the Bible says, but they haven't had that presence. So all they have is this head knowledge, but they haven't had that love encounter, and they're not changed. So, most of us haven't seen God, but that doesn't mean he's not real. The thing is, we have to know he's real based on more than his word. And it's that heart knowledge. It's that love encounter that goes, oh, wow, I know that he is real. This is not just a book for me to read and gain some facts from and some information about history. It is real. And head knowledge can also become kind of rule oriented, but heart knowledge becomes relationship oriented. So head knowledge is more about here's what it says to do, here's what we're going to do. But heart knowledge is takes it so much deeper than that. Because the thing is, with that relationship knowledge, you want to do the things to please God. You want to do what it says in his word, to love people, right? Head knowledge can only take you so far. But a lot of people aren't okay with mystery. They want to know all the details of this and that and the other. And they want to understand all the intricacies and all the different pieces. But then that takes the mystery away, and you'll never take the mystery out of God. So you're just going to have to be okay with mystery. You're going to have to be okay with not understanding everything. And if you seek his presence and you get into his presence, that will build your faith. Because making a decision based on all the facts doesn't really require any faith, right? Just doesn't. So seeking his presence requires faith, that he's already there. And if you want to make him aware, if you want him to make you aware of his presence, you got to let things go. You got to focus your mind. You got to focus your imagination and your mind on him and what he might be doing in your heart at that moment. You can't be so focused on what happened at work or what happened with my kids or what's happening in the kids ministry right now or what's going on, you know, later on tonight, what's happening tomorrow or what's happening this weekend. You have to be just focused on his presence, because his felt presence will change you forever. And the enemy wants nothing more than to make you think it's all made up, to make you think all the emotional part of it is just emotions. But that is not true. God is an emotional God. He gave us emotions on purpose. So I say pursue him. Take some time alone and turn on worship music and really press into his presence. Just take that leap of faith without understanding everything. Press in and you will be forever marked and forever changed. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith living in us, it's impossible to please God. We have to have the faith that he is real, that his presence can be felt today, not just in heaven, today on the earth. Remember, in Matthew 6, it talks about we want his kingdom here on earth. Not earth's kingdom on heaven. We want heaven's kingdom here on earth. That's going to take moments in his presence. That's going to take downloads from him, which are only going to happen in his presence. It also says in Hebrews 11:6, for we come to God in faith, knowing that he is real and that he rewards the faith of those who give all of their passion and strength into seeking him. Matthew 6:33 says, so above all, constantly chase after the realm of God's kingdom and the righteousness that proceeds from him. Constantly chase, constantly chase. Then all those less important things will be given to you abundantly. The less important things that it talks about in Matthew 6 is like, you know, having clothes to wear and food to eat and all that stuff. Not that those are obviously very important, but his presence is more important, because that is what gets you through everything you need to go through in life. So I'm hoping that this encouraged you to go deeper, to seek his presence, to not worry so much about facts and knowledge. Those things are important and there's a place for them, but without the presence, it's only half the picture and you need the whole picture. So find us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube at The Barn Ministries, or our website is thebarn.church. We'll see you next week on Reload, next Wednesday at noon Eastern time.